Alright y'all, welcome back to Covered Arms Channel. Okay, so today we're checking out the Royal Marine Commandos in Norway. We checked out a few videos of them doing this sort of training previously, but this is cool. This is like someone's like personal footage that they sort of made into like a video montage. I gotta say, it looks pretty awesome. I love checking out the Royal Marines in Norway, especially because like we know they're pretty solid when it comes to like the Arctic environments. And I think the relationship between the Royal Marine Commandos and Norway is a pretty old one, so it's kind of cool to see how it's advanced from this point. But I guess this video is going over an amphibious assault, which makes it even more interesting because, like, we're looking at the SRS, I think it was, them combining, like, the, you know, the sort of recon or, like, advanced party kind of stuff. But when you're doing that, it's, like, amphibious and also in the Arctic Circle, it just blows my mind because it just sounds really, really brutal. But should be cool. Let's check it out. Oh my gosh. Yeah, no thanks. You guys already know I don't like the cold. But cold and water? They must have some really solid equipment to make it somewhat conducive. That's a cool view. What the heck? Okay, so we're seeing a couple of water vessels already. This one looks pretty freaking sweet. I don't think I've seen it before. It kind of looks like it's designed for this sort of environment. Maybe it looks a little bit more like conducive if there's like ice in the water or something. I'm not sure if Norway even like really gets so much ice in the water in like these locations, but it looks pretty cold. I don't know. I can't imagine these would have like that much insulation. So I wonder how cold it actually gets like on the inside. And I'm sure these things actually have to go all the way onto the shore because going through this water a little bit is going to be brutal, even if you have like really solid equipment. But okay, we saw that one, and then we saw a couple of these sorts of rafts. Again, it looks like these are a little bit more rigid, or I don't know, the shape just looks a little bit more like defined. I don't know, it's kind of cool though. All the machine guns and whatnot. Damn, look at that freaking weather, dude. Choppy water, just blowing cold rain at you. Holy cow. That's very precarious. Oh, he is gonna go through the water. Oh, he's got like, yeah, they got really thick gloves and whatnot. I like how he's stepping. It's like, oh shit, it's cold. Right into the snow, okay. I know I was watching like videos before where, you know, I was talking about the snow and how it probably gets everything really wet. But yeah, I'm not really used to being in environments where it gets so cold that the snow is kind of just like not wet, like really like dry snow. So that makes a lot of sense. But even still, these guys walking through the wet water and then going through the snow is probably not going to help with that. Just goes to show how freaking tough they are. Jeez. It makes for some really solid footage. I'm surprised the footage came out so clear. Oh, they look like they're having a lot of fun. Damn, that's a really small raft, huh? Like a fire team size raft. That's sick. I don't know how he got so many angles. Nice, okay. This is always super interesting to me. Damn, that backpack looks super freaking heavy. And you guys already know I love checking out the actual like snow camouflage or like the application of it. Cause you can see here, I guess they have like some sort of white tape and you can see the attention to detail with them just putting it on the rails here. That's pretty freaking cool. But yeah, it looks very heavy and especially with the over boots, I can't imagine it would be like that easy to move around. I'm sure they're not moving too far in this sort of specific load cause this is more of like amphibious load. I imagine when they land, they're going to like reorient and whatnot, but yeah, this looks pretty freaking heavy, but again, it looks super cool. Seeing the Royal Marine Commandos doing anything Arctic is always really cool because I don't really have any experience when it comes to cold weather stuff, so I kind of get ideas just watching what they're doing. What is that thing? Is that like a Norwegian vessel? A Navy ship or something? Maybe like a cargo ship. Oh nice, they got the gunships too. So it is an amphibious assault, so... Damn, that looks brutal. Just walking against the winds. Nice, so they got like some proper CQB going on too. I wonder if they're gonna breach, they have like the door set up. Nice, hell yeah, dude. That's so freaking cool. It just looks badass. Again, the snow, not a fan of it, but it makes everything look cool, especially when you got the snow camo. It's a nice little facility. I wonder if the gunships are gonna like start doing some runs, some gun runs or something. Oh, nice! Yeah, what's that? That must have been like a fixed wing ordnance. Dude, this is a proper shoot house too. Oh, and they got strobes, dude. This is freaking legit. He's got a GoPro on his. Of course. Damn, you can still tell how cold it is. And they got like the gloves still. But those aren't like the winter gloves, so I imagine their hands are still getting pretty cold. Yeah, I gotta say, from my experience just dealing with like the cold weather stuff, is everything, it just becomes more difficult because things just start freezing, things get wet, your hands start freezing, you can't do like just simple manipulations as easily, especially if you have like thick mitts or what have you. But yeah, you definitely need the right equipment. It seems like the Royal Marines, again, they have a lot of experience, especially working in Norway. So they always seem to have, you know, exactly what they need. Kind of like a lessons learned. It's exactly what you would expect. But this is cool. I gotta say, I don't see a whole lot of like personal Royal Marines like footage. I'm not sure if that's like a specific reason, if you all have to go through like certain channels to get like certain, you know, training videos released or what have you. But if you guys have any other cool like personal clips or like video montages like this, definitely send them my way because they're always really kind of interesting. It's cool to get like a general perspective, something that was organized by like the military's combat camera or whoever's, you know, in charge of getting all the clips and putting them together. But having like one person's perspective is kind of cool as well because you can sort of get in the mind of one specific unit or one specific team and sort of see how they train, see what, you know, their SOPs are, their standing operating procedures for like their camouflage, their kits, how do they secure their kits, and how they sort of do everything. So it's kind of cool getting to that tactical level, if you will. But yeah, let me know if you guys have anything to recommend. Throw it down below, or you can head over to the Discord. And of course, you guys might have seen that I have some merch with this subliminal messaging. So if you want to check that out, I have a link in the video description. But thank you guys again for supporting the channel. These are really cool, especially because these are like a little bit more low key when it's like someone's personal videos and they don't have that many like views yet. It's always cool to sort of stumble upon those and just see the quality that we get because this is pretty well put together. So kudos. I will put the original video in the description so you guys can go check out that video and check out that channel. But thank you for watching. That's it for this one. I'll see you all in the next one.